told me to be funny, concise, and don't talk too much. So I'm gonna try to take that advice and introduce to you the lady who runs the city of New Orleans, the first female to be elected in the 300-year history of the city of New Orleans. Ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Mayor LaToya Cantrell.
Thank you, Julius. All right, good morning. Happy Mardi Gras. Happy King's Day. It truly is a beautiful, beautiful morning and a special, special day in the city of New Orleans and no like any other place in the world on this day. Thank you so much. Of course, our leadership here, leading the Mayor's Mardi Gras Advisory Committee, James and Elroy, I just can't say enough about you. Steering us through some of our most difficult times, but also steering us towards our best times. Thank you so much. Miss Universe, thank you for being here with us. We look forward to hosting Miss Universe pageant here in our city in the upcoming weeks. That's a big deal for the city of New Orleans, which we are a world-class city. Thank you so much. Now, you know, as I mentioned, I gave a little shout out, you know, of course, for those on the dais. But this is, we're embarking upon really the second year since we've lost the true Mr. Mardi Gras, Mr. Blaine Kern. And keeping that legacy alive has been that of Barry, and I have to say Fitz, for continuing the legacy, for what you do for our city, for our state, across the world. And even here recently, transforming what we know now as our Children's Hospital Christmas Parade, we brought that special magic to the city of New Orleans in a very special way, and I thank you for that. You know, Barry, you're becoming to be one of the best people and a friend to me, not only in this leadership as mayor, but just throughout the time of service. You stand up, you never falter, and you move forward. I appreciate you, I value you, and let's give him another round of applause. It matters. You know, as we reflect on a safe, fun, and friendly 22 Mardi Gras season we had, we're wanting to continue that momentum for Mardi Gras 2023. We know that a successful Mardi Gras season depends on safe celebrations and proper preparation. Now, your city, our city, we really take great pride in preparing ourselves for whatever comes our way. But clearly when it comes on standing up and putting up Mardi Gras for the world and for our city, we are always wanting to take and make the best steps to make us safer. And so with that, as we look upon 2023, I wanted to let you know that I'm asking you all to join the city of New Orleans in making sure that our streets are safe. And what we're doing here, and I'm announcing it right now, and now this isn't the first time, of reaching out and encouraging all of our law enforcement agencies around the state and even throughout the federal government to come on in and partner with the city of New Orleans so that again, we can have the safest celebration in history. But this year is something a little bit more special. We're putting a little bit more meat on the bone, as I like to say. We are prepared to invite and pay for any post-certified law enforcement agency to support us in this endeavor. Again, we are willing to pay so that our New Orleans Police Department, our public safety team, our unified command has every layer of support that we need, that you need, present throughout the streets of New Orleans to ensure that we have a safe Mardi Gras 2023. Now, New Orleans is very known for having safe celebrations. This isn't new. However, we do understand the challenges that we face relative to capacity. That's not just about our law enforcement agency, NOPD, but we're really seeing the capacity issues across the board. But with that, we're wanting to ensure a safe celebration. So, putting resources on the table, again, we are prepared to invite and pay for any post-certified law enforcement agency to support us this carnival season. I'm saying today, if we collectively find the officers needed to support our crews returning to the streets of New Orleans, there will be no real discussions about which routes are going to be affected or not. But I will say, on today, Endymion will return to the streets of New Orleans in its traditional formation and the traditional route. Let's give it up for that. Public safety will always definitely be in its place and remaining a top priority for the city of New Orleans. But this is our time to put our best foot forward and to create a win-win as it relates to Mardi Gras 2023 and keeping our residents and our visitors safe. We're also going to help make Mardi Gras more sustainable. As you know, many of our crews have started on this path, whether it's muses, wrecks, and the like. But we're expanding the bead recycling program, the operations all along the entire parade route. Again, trying to make our city more resilient as well as be sustainable. We know that we're on the front lines of climate that has already changed. We've seen this time and time again. So making sure, again, that we do the best and take the best steps to ensure the safety of our community and how we are known across the world for our resilience. I want our people to visit ready.nola.gov. You will get all of our city tips on Mardi Gras in terms of safety so that everyone is prepared. You will also hear tips about transportation, first aid stations that we will continue to have along the routes, restrooms, required permits, prohibited items, and so much more. Carnival is for all of us. All of us. Every neighborhood, all of our residents. And so I'm going to give a special shout out and even an encouragement for our residents to keep the, you know what we had, porch floats. Keep those porch floats alive during 2023. So a special shout out to Renee Pierre with Crescent City Artists who are responsible for creating the Mardi Gras porch floats. Again, let's keep that tradition going and alive in our city. I want to acknowledge all that are here. Special love to the New Orleans City Council. Thank you so much for being here. Let's show them some love and appreciation. None of this happens on its own. It's a unified partnership. Also, I have my senior team is here this morning. I invited them here this morning so that they too can get the much love due to them, because again, none of this happens alone. And so while our public safety team is always in the forefront, and we definitely need them, but it takes all branches of government, all city departments to pull off Mardi Gras. So let's give the senior team of the City of New Orleans a warm round of applause, acknowledging my CAO, Gilbert Montano. Gilbert, thank you for being here. So with that, I'm going to turn it back over to Julius. But let's have a happy and safe and fun Mardi Gras season. We know that we put on the best free show on earth. But let's continue to demonstrate what this city is and what she means, not only to the residents of this city, not only to the state of Louisiana, or the United States of America, but to the world. We are a world-class city. And give it up for the City of New Orleans.
Thank you, Madam Mayor.